What's up, guys? How you guys doing? I go by the name Krizbeatz, the drummer boy, and you're welcome to my YouTube tutorials again. By now, I'm sure you guys already know that today is another edition of Krizbeatz 101, the tutorial of how I make most of my songs that you guys like. And today, I'm actually excited about this one because the song, there's actually a whole lot of things going on the internet about this song, and so I want to let you guys in on what really went down, how the song came to be. For Life by Runtown. I want to love you for life. You know, for those of you that don't know, Runtown is actually a music producer, so he sent me the song. He sent me the song and told me, yo, Chris, I would like you to like mess this beat up more for me, because he came up with the beat originally. So he sent the beat. I said no, that I don't like the drums and all. So he said okay, that I can change anything, I can remove anything. So I removed all the drums and I was left with this. Just this. The pad. I didn't change this. This is the same way this came from Runtown, like this. So what I did was, okay, I throw in some bounce to it. So, and if you are watching this video and you have not subscribed, you just came to peek, you just came to like view and just go, nah, you shouldn't do that. Join the trend, you know, join the family, be one of the new waves in town, you know what I mean? So subscribe, like, comment, hit me up if you feel you need anything concerning your production and all. I'll be free and open to let you know anything you want to know. So I mean, if I know it, and if you know something that you want me, you feel okay, Krizbeatz, if you add this to your sound, it will help you, be open. I mean, it's a free word, you know. Let me know something, I'll teach you. I'm even going an extra mile to teach you guys some of the stuffs I do. I'm sure nobody does that in this country right now. So I'm not trying to brag about it, but I mean, it's good. Shout out to my manager for letting this happen, because he wanted to like share the knowledge and I bought the idea. So yeah, so I went straight ahead. Remember I said I don't like to start my beats with the pad, because it kind of like limits me. I won't be able to do too many stuffs on the beat, because I feel they sound great already. So with this one, the first thing I did was, after this part, I added the snare. Sounds like this together. Remember, don't start a beat without your metronome if you don't want to mess things up. So here, the BPM for the song is 103. 103, in case you want to make the beat along with me. So 103, get your headphones. Let's jam. So sounds like this. Then after this, I added a roll. Remember the runs, the roll that gives you, the swing roll that gives you the groove, so your beat, so the beat doesn't sound like the Afro, you know, it's Afro beat. It doesn't sound laggy. Yeah, so you add the roll to it to give it that. This. 1, 2, 3, go. You know. Then after this, I didn't want to be wasting too much time, okay, doing that. So adding too many stuffs, I just added the kick straight. So sounds like this, you know. With this, I wanted something outside the box, like something to give me more African groove. I needed something to give me more African groove. So I took a muted bass, and I filtered it, cut off the low. Sounds like this. I I don't know if you can really hear that, but let me mute it. Sounds like me. Let me solo it. So I added this guy here. So with the pad from Runtown. Yeah, so the song, we have the song, you have the groove already in, of the song. So the little things that people don't actually pay attention to that makes a sweet song is actually some of these things. You know, I have this Krizbeatz signature. I told you guys the first tutorial we did, that's the panel review, that anywhere you hear this sound, that sound, you know. That is Krizbeatz. So right now in the country, a whole lot of people are doing this. I should sue y'all. But trust me, I just want a knowledge for all. So I'm leaving you guys to do it. You know, you could mess with it. Anyway, you hear this? Trust me, that's Krizbeatz. So I did that in this song, so sounds like this together. Because remember what I told you about attention, your beat telling people a story. Okay, this beat is actually telling me, Chris, that okay, I'm in love with somebody. That's the story. I'm in love with somebody that does not know it. You get? I'm saying my story now. My story of the beat is different from what the artist once on the beat. Your beat should tell you a story. Anytime you listen to the beat, you listen to it because you listen to it from beginning to the end because it's actually telling you something. You get so like this. See. Here, you know, I see myself talking to the girl, you know, the girl not knowing how I actually feel about her, all those things, you know. So that is the vision I have in my head while creating the beat before the artist, this thing. But in this case, I had an idea of what he wants to sing in the on the beat rather. So I added this guy here. So after this guy, there's another groove that we added. You need to see Runtown was already feeling the whole groove here in the studio. He was seated here. If he was in the country, he would have been available for this tutorial video. But I'm sure he's watching right now. So after this, after the whole guy, after this, all these guys here, another thing I did was this. So I used this 808 conga to achieve that pum pum. I don't know if you can hear it. You need a set of headphones or a good monitor to hear this. Yeah, that. Together. Sounds like this together. Okay, yeah. Then before the vocals comes in, there's this Krizbeatz signature sound again. You know, in you probably hear there's one or whip or yeah or it or anything, you know. So those are the kind of stuffs I have. Don't worry. Trust me, you get all these things in my sound pack. This one sounds like this. This one sounds like this. Wait, 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 wait. Yeah. Wait, wait. Yeah, so it comes in every 4/4 bar. So after that, I added another strings, you know, to the pad that Runtown sent. This. This one. Trust me, if you really listen to the song, they have they are actually two different songs. Trust me. The only reason why you might want to relate it to the other song is because the way he sang it, the way he was bouncing to it. And trust me, it's his song. I mean, that's his. We've heard Runtown is actually one of the few artists in Nigeria that I respect so much that can do anything, you understand? So shout out to him, man. Shout out to everyone on his team for coming hard on that one. So he told me he wanted this vamp. This vamp is the thing that is reminding people of Mad Over You, that this one here. I mean, if you ask me, I would say it is Runtown's. This is Runtown's wave, you know, is like telling Drake not to use a dark pad in his song, you know. It's like there's no Drake without dark pad. So why don't we go and tell Drake that he's giving us the same sound because he has he's always using the same dark pad? And why don't we tell Future that he's doing the same bounce in this thing? So I just think you guys should just enjoy. Let's just enjoy the good music. Let's just do music and have fun, feel good. Everybody makes money. And if you're a young producer out there, get your publishing right so you don't bite your fingers. Well, no, that's a popping ace. You understand? So, yeah. So he told me that, Chris, let's have this vamp. Bam. So we added that pam. Don't mind me. I can be saucy sometimes. So, here. Okay, sorry, I got carried away. I was enjoying myself. So we looped that. Okay, this line actually played for 8 bar. From here, let me play with the vocals on it. Oh, sorry. I forgot to tell you. The intro. There's a particular software on Reason, Neptune. Neptune is like a pitch corrector. I went to pick an Indian song, an a cappella. I tweaked it to the key of the song. Then I tweaked it to the key of the song. Sounds like this. Yeah. Trust me, it's crazy. This thing took like, Runtown was literally sleeping. He was literally sleeping on the thing while I was doing this one because it was taking too much time. Trust me, if you want to do stuff like this, you should do it before your client comes. You understand? So I was doing it. I went to the internet searching for something that sounds good that I can use. I time stretched it to the song and came out pretty good. And I'm sure that's like one of the things people love most when they listen to my stuff is like, okay, different sounds. They don't know something weird is happening in the beat somewhere, you know. So this came in. So and I use a Miranda, a big Kalimba. What's the name? Is it Kalimba? Wait, let me check. Really, it's Martin Duran, I guess. Abby? Yeah. Very well, look at Kenny and Kimara, exist. Marimba. So, I used a marimba sound after this, this one here. So, so like this. Remember this same jazz guitar from Contact. Marimba from Logic. So together they sound like this. So with the intro and everything, with the beats and all, they sound like this all together. So the whip, the clap, the Krizbeatz popular clap sound, and I added one thing I hardly do in my beats to add a violin. You know, I'm not really a fan of sounds like that, but it was needed in this song, so I added it. This one. It's actually a cello. So I added this cello to give it that I'm in love feel. Like you want to, like that's Titanic, I want to die for something. Somebody wants to die for love and all those kind of stuff. Remember I said you should always interpret it. You should always interpret your beats. Try to like let what you are playing sound similar to what the artist is doing. So.
My doctor say my girl dey on top your body. All the things where I do you bad, I'm sad. Give me love way better pass money. Way sweet pass honey. In that ride, make a fight for the love.
So here, the only thing that changed from that place to this part is this guitar that comes in again. So So to give it that eastern feel, that's eastern part of Nigeria. That's like the whole of the song. That's few instruments, few thing, and Runtown came hard on it. We have the song there, Runtown for Life. And if you haven't subscribed, please do right now. Comment below. Let me know what other song you want me to do. Let me know other Krizbeatz sounds you want to know how I achieve them. Trust me, comment here, like, subscribe. God bless you. Krizbeatz loves you. I want to love you for life.